Today we're going to transfer a 360-degree 3D MP4 file to the Oculus Go through its USB port, so that you can view the video at a later time offline. There are quite a few apps that allow you to stream 3D videos on your Oculus, like YouTube VR, Samsung VR Videos, and Oculus Video. But there are times when you may want to watch 3D videos offline or avoid logging into Facebook just to watch some movies, whether at a friend's house or on a trip out of state. The first thing you'll want to do, of course, is to download the video or movie onto your PC. Simply searching for something like Free VR Movie Download in your favorite search engine will give you plenty of options for downloading videos. I'll let you decide what you want to use, but for the purpose of this tutorial, I already have a file downloaded and prepared. For 3D videos, the file will typically be in an MP4 container. The Oculus can support H.264 encoding up to a resolution of 4096 by 2048 at 60 frames per second, or H.265 encoding up to 4096 by 4096 at 30 frames per second. When you open it up in Windows Media Player, which can't handle displaying 3D formats, you'll see something like this, where you have the two stereoscopic images, top and bottom, in either full or half resolution. Other videos may have the images side by side, like this. In either case, the Oculus Go will be able to decode the 3D. If you open the file in the Movies and TV application, you'll be able to click and drag your mouse within the image to rotate the view in all directions. After you turn on the Oculus Go, the next step is to connect the microUSB cable. You'll want to take off the headset, then plug in the microUSB connector into the Oculus, and the other side of the cable into a USB port of the computer. You'll see it being recognized in Windows, and when I open File Explorer, the VR headset will appear as a device. However, when you click on it, no subfolders or files will appear. What you'll need to do is put on the Oculus again, at which point you should see a dialog box asking you to allow access to data. Now, even before this, depending on how long you've had your headset off, you may be presented with a request to reorient your view, which you can do by long pressing the Oculus button. You'll then want to hit Allow to give your PC access to the Oculus. Now we can take the headset off and go back to Windows. Once we reopen File Explorer and enter the VR headset, we can drill down to the subfolders. You'll want to choose the Movies folder and copy over the downloaded file by dragging and dropping it. Depending on the size of the file, this can take some time, so I'll take a quick break and heat some mozzarella sticks in the toaster oven. Okay, we're back. We can now unplug the USB cable from the Oculus and return to the headset. At this point, go ahead and navigate to the free Oculus Gallery app. Once the source selector pops up, you'll want to choose Internal Storage, at which point you'll see the file that you've copied over from the PC. Depending on the file name of the video, you may or may not see it in full stereoscopic 3D. Should it come up in 2D, where you're sitting in a theater, click the trigger button on the controller, which will bring up the different 2D and 3D modes to which you can switch. You can also manually change whether the video is side by side or top and bottom. After hitting the 360 3D icon, the video will appear in that mode, where you'll be able to spin in your office chair or turn your head in any direction. If you want the video to come up in the correct mode automatically, and you know the format of the video beforehand, you can rename the file itself before you copy it to the Oculus. Simply add an underscore 360 to the end of the file name, and if it's top and bottom, add an additional underscore TB. If it's side by side, add an underscore LR instead. After you transfer it to the headset, Oculus Gallery will play it back in the format that you defined in the file name. I hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching.